Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel on Advanced Excel. Today we are going to see sum and sumifs with index and match for dynamic sum range. Okay, now I assume that all of you must be already using this sum and sumifs. So we'll start with sumifs. Suppose this is my salary register and it has got employee name, cost center, basic, HRA and bonus. And just type here cost center. Now I have prepared this drop down list using data validation tool. So I'll just say cost center is 100, component is say basic, and we'll try to use this sumifs, and we'll stick to this basic right now, right? So sumifs tab, my sum range is going to be basic, which is this. Then my criteria range 1 is going to be this cost center, and my criteria will be this cost center, bracket complete, control enter. So this is my sum of basic for cost center 1000, and here it is, say 1, 2 and 3, right? 164779. But friends, what if I change this to HRA? Even when I am changing this to HRA, my sum, my result is the same. Result is not getting changed. Okay. So here we want something which will basically make this sum range a dynamic thing or a volatile. Okay. So the moment I put here a different component name, and if I change the cost center, the automatically the result has to be a different. So here we will have to change this part of the sumifs function. And we are going to replace this with index and match. We will say index always asks for array. Array is going to be this. Array is basically range of cell where my result is lying. Okay, so here these are the range of cells where my result is lying. It can either be a sum of basic or a sum of HRA or sum of bonus. So this is where my result is lying. Now row number, that is how many rows you want to go down. I don't want to go down any rows, so I'll just put comma. Then how many columns you want to move. So here I am going to use match. So array is given, for row number I am putting comma, and my column number will be taken care by match. So I'll say match tab, my lookup value is going to be HRA, my lookup array is going to be basic, HRA and bonus, these three columns. Now those of you who have seen my videos on index and match, I have said then that whenever you are using index and match together, one has to ensure that the array or lookup array for the purpose of match and for the purpose of index, they have to be of the same dimensions. Okay, so in this index, my column consists of only three columns, and here for lookup array also my columns are only three. Okay, so they have to be of the same size. If they are of the different size, then you may get a result, but it could be a very well wrong result, right? So my lookup array is given, then my match type is going to be exact match, and I will complete the brackets for match, and now I am completing the brackets for index. Again it has brought me back to sumifs, and the rest things are unchanged. That is, my criteria is still the cost center, and my criteria range is going to be a cost center, and my cost center is going to be 1000. So we are done with this. So control enter, here it is. Okay, so now for HRA and for cost center 1000, the amount is 82390. How it is? 1, 2 and 3, 82390. Now let's change this to bonus. I'll just say bonus, it will be 60000 now, isn't it? Bonus 60000. Here it is. Now let also change the cost center from say 1000 to 1001. So for 1001 cost center and bonus component, how much should be the total? 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1,60,000. Here it is. 1,60,000. Okay. So by using index and match and integrating it with sumifs, you can basically make this sum range a volatile, or make this sum range as a dynamic thing, so that the moment you change this heading or a component, you get the answer for that particular component, right? And let me just evaluate this thing for you. So I'll go to formulas, evaluate formula. Now I have said that whenever Excel evaluates a formula, it evaluates from inside to outside. So right now the innermost function is match, so it is evaluating match. It is evaluating this H6 within that lookup range, which is C1 to E1. So evaluate. So now match has got this basic. Now it will throw the position of this basic in the lookup array. So now position of that basic in the lookup array is 1, okay, because in that table array of this C1, D1 and E1, basic stands at position number 1. Now having done that, now in what it brings me back to index. Now index has got hold of this entire array, which starts from C2 to E13, okay, and in that E13, the match has fetched me a result that is 1. So now the sum fs will take the total of column number 1 in the table array, which is in fact supported by match, which is fetching me result 1, that is for the basic. So now if I press evaluate, it will give me 217 217. Let us see, is it that 217 217 for 1 0 0 1 1 2 3 and 4? Yes, it is 217 217. Okay, so this is how you can use index and match with SumFS. Now let me just show you two more examples using index and match with just sum, right? So I'll just type here Jan, my month, and now my data is in a vertical format. So each column has got this label of name of the month and the total of this five amounts. So I'll say is equal to sum. Now analogy is going to remain the same. So I'll say sum. Now for range, sum always asks for range. So I'll say index tab. My array for the purpose of index is this. I need not include this sum, sir. Then comma. Now it is asking for row number. Now either you can keep this row number blank or you can just put 0. It does not make any difference. And for column, I will say again match tab, lookup value is Jan. My lookup array is going to be from B16 to G16, which is of the same size as that of index, comma. My lookup is going to be exact match. I will complete parenthesis for match, and now I am completing the parenthesis for index. Now it is bringing me back to sum and control enter. Yes, 695, here it is. Now if I change this to say May, it will give me 606, here it is. Okay, so when your data is in a vertical format, in the match you will give argument which will complement the column number condition in index, okay, and that way you can get a sum of the month you want to have. So if I change this to say April, it should give me 658, here it is. Okay, now I have got similar example, but the only difference is now my data is in a row, that is it's in a horizontal format. So again I'll say April, so that now the results are comparable. I'll say again sum tab, index tab. My index is going to be now this one. Array is going to be from C24 to G29. Okay, now my row number is going to be fetched by match, okay, because my data is in a horizontal format. So I will say match tab, I say April. Now my lookup array is going to be of the same size as that of index, comma. The match is going to be exact match, so I'll put 0. Now it is again bringing me back to index, and it is asking for a column number. I'll just put comma, or I can put zero also, and I'll then change. Complete the parenthesis for match, and complete the same for index 658. Okay, so April 658, and even when your data is in a horizontal format, it is giving this 658 result. Right. So whenever you have a scenario where now you are asked to prepare some kind of a dashboard, where the moment you change this month to say Feb, it should give you a sum of Feb. Then you can use this index and match, and you can integrate this index and match with sum or a sum if, or you can even integrate it with average if or even count if to get the result. So friends, this brings me to the end of the video. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel, and also hit the bell icon to get notifications of my upcoming video. Thanks a lot. Bye.